Hello there. Good morning. Yeah, good evening. I know it is still early for a 10 o'clock broadcast, but let us just do it this way. This evening, I will be broadcasting earlier than 1 hour. Bob Miramar once again in the Day of Hope in the Lord Jesus Christ, live broadcast over FB, wishing you a very successful Tuesday evening, the second day of the Holy Week. And so this reminds us of the great love of God towards each of us, that He gave His only begotten Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, because He loves us, and the Lord Jesus Christ so loves us. And so friends, I know many of you are now on queue, whether by the seaport or the airport, or in the bus terminals. Many of you are transient already, maybe. Many of you are still preparing. Some of you are still preparing to leave for your towards your provinces. And our Word of Hope brethren, Word of Hope Medical and Dental Missions team, they already had 1 day of medical missions today in Capiz City, in Antique and Iloilo. So, wishing you the best over there. I was not able to go with you, and so I'm just relying on your reports through FB of what's happening there. And I really am glad when I saw the posting of Reverend Ismael Serna, when he said many souls had accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. Why? Because that is the most important reason why God had to send His only begotten Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, to earth. And so tonight, as we are pondering over this Holy Week, I am giving you an exhortation, so simply entitled, "And the Lord Jesus gave Himself to us, to save us, to ransom us, because He loves us." Alright? So, magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Brother Romy Retiban, you are coming from the Middle East. And itong sila, Sister Rose Ompoco. I don't know if she is in San Jose del Monte, Bulacan right now, or still at work. And Melvin Gallardo Lozano, thank you for watching. And yeah, my daughter, Joyce Miramar, down under in the first level of our unit. Well, let us just continue to pray that God would touch many lives, especially this Holy Week. And many would come to know that the Lord Jesus Christ had given Himself for each of them too. And it is our honor that He had included us in His master list of, in His roster actually, of His co-laborers in His vineyard. And so this is one thing, how to spread out love, how to spread out the good news, the gospel of salvation. For the Lord loves us, and He gave Himself for us because He wanted to ransom us. So my batchmate, Acela Villanueva Chiano, thank you for watching. You're coming from Cebu. And so I will be reading coming from Galatians 1 verse 4, and the Bible says, "Who gave Himself for our sins, that He might deliver us from this present evil age, according to the will of God and Father." According to the will of God and Father. Jesus Christ obeyed. He obeyed sincerely to the will of God the Father. God the Son obeyed His God and Father, and now He made us His, Jesus Christ made us adopted children of God, and so to be co-heirs of Him together with Him because of the original Son's love, and not just affection but concern and self-sacrificial offering, that He made us partakers of the heavenly inheritance. So the Bible says, according to Apostle Paul, "And He gave Himself Number one reason, to save us. He gave himself for our sins in exchange to our sins, so that he can also deliver us from this evil age. So there is this progressive, effectual of his loving kindness, progressive, effectual power of his deliverance, that once a person accepts the Lord Jesus Christ, and once that person who accepted the Lord Jesus Christ walks on his way towards becoming closer and living as an adopted child of God, he is promised by the Lord that the Lord shall continue to deliver him from evil, all right? From here, from this evil age until eternity, because that is the will of God the Father. Sister Lydia San Miguel, thank you for watching. And also, what is found in Galatians chapter 2, the following chapter, and in verse 20, the great apostle Paul himself, he said, I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. Lives, present tense, including to that progressive effectual power of God over us, giving us protection and giving us even the provisions, because we are now being made children of God together with Christ. But Christ lives in me, and the life which I now live in the flesh, very clear, I live by faith in the Son of God, which is Jesus Christ. God who wills for each one to come to know the Lord Jesus Christ, who loved me and gave himself for me. Christ gave himself for us, for our sins, to ransom us. Why? Because God and the Lord Jesus Christ loved us. Question, is there anybody that had already given his life for you, died for you, suffered for you, just to get your heart, just to get your attention? He suffered and died. Do you know somebody aside from Jesus Christ? If yes, very good. But the Lord Jesus Christ did it personally to each of us, you and I, but also for the whole world. Another question, follow-up question. Is there anyone, aside from Jesus Christ, who gave himself, offered himself as a sacrifice, just to get our attention, just to get our heart, and not us, but the whole world? Oh, there's none. Yeah, there's none. Only the Lord Jesus Christ did it. And so the Apostle Paul had to say, the life that I live in this flesh now, I live it by faith in the Son of God. Why? The Son of God loved him and loved us. And because of that love, he gave himself for us. Apostle Paul says, he gave himself for me. Now, in 1 Timothy chapter 6, what the Bible says? For there is one God, and there is one mediator. God is another. God the Son is another. God the Son is called the mediator. God the Father, God is called God the Father. There is one God and one mediator between God and man, the man, Christ Jesus, who gave himself a ransom for all, to be testified in due time, for which I was appointed a preacher and an apostle. I am speaking the truth in Christ and not lying, a teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. Who Apostle Paul was? The teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. What the great apostle teaches? There is only one mediator, and His name is Jesus Christ. And this mediator is no longer an alien to anybody who believes in His name. Why? Once a person believes in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord Jesus Christ enters into the life of that person, and that life of that person is going to be changed. And that person is going to live that life just like Apostle Paul. No longer he, but the Christ that lives in him. And so that life shall be lived out in faith and in truth. Because God loves us. You see, God empowers us with such power that is not just an ordinary power. Because God loves you, He empowers you not just an ordinary power, not just like any other worldly powers, but it is a heavenly power. And that power is not just being represented to us by anyone else, an emissary or a secretary of the board or the business executive secretary, or anyone that can represent, but the Lord Jesus Christ Himself. Imagine this. The Lord Jesus Christ Himself in us, in you, that believes in Him. The only begotten Son of God. He gave Himself to be the ransom for you to be redeemed, for me to be redeemed and to be saved, to become adopted as a child of God, the Father, according to the firstborn child's authority and power, the Lord Jesus Christ, which is the begotten Son of God. Remember, John 1:12, it says, "For as many as those who have come to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, He gave them the authority to become children of God." Without Jesus Christ, there should be no authority and power. Not even a single special power of attorney that can make us a child of God or children of God. But only because the Lord Jesus Christ gave himself for each of us. Friends, thank you that you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you that you have accepted Him and you have received Him. Why? The Lord Jesus Christ now lives in your heart. And so what we need to do, number one, is to allow the Lord Jesus Christ to drive this life. Next, allowing Him to plot the course of this life. Driving, actually, meaning bringing this life to where He wants us to go. And then plotting, meaning planning and making the rerouting if it is necessary to be done. Giving directions. What I wanted to say is give the Lord Jesus Christ full control. Would it be hard for you to do it? Would it be hard for you to give Jesus Christ control? Oh, by the way, the reason why in this Christian faith's life, guidelines for living, remember, the reason behind why there are so many conflicts happening in our hearts is this. The Lord Jesus Christ wanted to pursue every plan according to God's will for your life. But we, as a person, human being, we tend, okay? Let me tell you that again. We tend to take control of this life and not giving it to Him. So, nagkakaroon ito ng conflict. Paano ko ito nasasabi? Ako mismo, I've experienced that many times. Iba yung gusto ko sa nais ng Panginoon. At yung nais ng Panginoon, hindi ko pinararaan yon. Ang ginagawa ko, yung gusto ko. What happened? I have to be checked. There must be so many rerouting, so to speak, in my life that the Lord has to make in order for me to be brought back to the right path. So friends, principles of living. Kailangan lang, we have to give full control to Jesus. How can we do that? By prayer and meditation upon His Word. If you would remember one of my broadcasts, I said, the Bible is very consistent from beginning to the end. So kung yun yung ating matututunan, well, because Jesus Christ gave Himself for us, because He loved us, He gave Himself for us to ransom us in order to save us from this present evil age, and then tomorrow another present day, because today will be yesterday when tomorrow comes. Present age na naman yun, the power of the Lord will continue to protect us. Now, I would like to continue to remember the five-letter P's that we can have as benefits when we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. He gives us His presence. He gives us His power. He empowered us. He gives us His protection. He gives us His provision. And He gives us His peace. Five-letter P's to remember. Friends, magandang-magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. At advance tayo ng 1 hour sa supposedly 10 o'clock broadcast natin. Why? I am so very excited to do this live broadcast and to share this afterwards. But please be with us also in praying, because we are now in the middle of our preparations, so that this coming May 5, to God be the glory, we can start up our Word of Hope Kainta Church inside the Santa Lucia East Grand Mall in Cinema Number 4. In Cinema Number 4. This is very much easy to locate. Ito ay nasa along the highway lamang po, at the corner po ng Felix Manalo Avenue, yung former Imelda Avenue, at ng Marcos Highway. Alright, pagkagaling kayo ng Marikina, makikita nyo yun doon papunta sa may Robinson's East Mall, at saka katabi niya yung Santa Lucia East Grand Mall. Cinema Number 4, lahat po ng nakatira sa Cuguio, Lower Antipolo, nakatira po dyan sa mga may southern part ng Marikina, southwestern part ng Marikina, at nakatira dito po sa western part ng Quezon City like Libis, Katipunan, at yun po nakatira sa Pasig, okay, northeastern and northwestern side ng Pasig. Kayo po ay aming inanyayahan na kung kayo ay naghahanap po ng inyong magiging home church to belong to worship the Lord and every Sunday, nandyan po tayo sa Cinema Number 4, Santa Lucia East Grand Mall ng Marcos Highway, corner Felix Avenue, Cainta City. At ito po ay sa alas 10 ng umaga. At yung isa po nating satellite church, daughter din po ito ng Word of Hope, at through the efforts of our brethren ng Word of Hope Manila, ay naroroon naman sa second floor ng bagong-bagong building, De Las Armas Building, dyan po sa Concepcion 1, Marikina City, just along J.P. Rizal Avenue, at just in front, opposite side of the Concepcion 1 Integrated School. This is very easy to locate, and so marami po tayong parking spaces doon. Yung other side, yung parking spaces po ng Concepcion 1 Integrated School, yun po yung aming ginagamit every Sunday. And see you there, okay? And let the Lord bless everybody. Sino man sa inyo ang mayroong mga kamag-anak at mga kaibigan na nakatira sa mga nabanggit ko pong mga lugar, you just try to notify us, at go to our Facebook, Word of Hope Kainta. Alright, Facebook natin, Word of Hope Kainta, at i-PM ninyo kami, at doon po sa ating Word of Hope Kainta at yahoo.com. Okay, Word of Hope Kainta at yahoo.com. O kaya, you can text us, or message us, or call us sa Globe numbers na ito, 0915-440-5893. O kaya, pumasyal na kayo ng diretso, ipagtanong ninyo po sa mga security guards, sapagkat meron pong dalawang side ang Santa Lucia East Grand Mall. Ang theaters number 6, 7, 8, and 9 to 10, ay naroon po sa bagong building. Pero yung theaters 1, 2, 3, and 4 ay nandito po sa old building. Mismong katabi po ng ginagawang LRT3 station. Okay? Madaling-madali po yan. LRT3 station ng Santa Lucia. So, God bless you. It is my prayer. Sino man ang may sakit at karamdaman at nasa sa matinding mga pangangailangan, God will bless you. At ang Holy Week na ito ay magiging tunay na victory mo. Healing, recovery, provisions, kapayapaan, tunay na pagpapala ng Panginoon. At kung ikaw ho ay naghahanap ng iba yung kapayapaan, iba yung direksyon ng buhay, you just ask the Lord. You can pray, you can bow your head and close your eyes and then concentrate unto the Lord at sasabihin mo, Panginoon, kinikilala ko po na ako'y isang tao din na nakagawa ng iba't ibang uri ng kasalanan at hindi ako karapat-dapat sa iyo. Kung kaya ako'y nananalig na iyong pagparito sa mundo, ikaw ay napahirapan at nagpatigis na iyong banal na dugo, namatay sa krus at inilibing at muling nagbangon mula sa mga patay at ngayon nabubuhay magpakailanpaman upang ako'y bigyan ng bagong uri ng buhay, kaligtasan ng aking kaluluwa at assurance ng akin pong katagumpayan sa buhay. Lord, patawarin mo ako sa aking mga kasalanan, linisin mo ako, Panginoong Jesus, at pumasok ka sa aking puso at buhay, pangunahan mo ako, take full control at ikaw na po ang siyang magdirihe ng aking pamumuhay hanggang sa huling araw ng aking buhay dito sa mundo. And Lord, salamat sa kaligtasan. Isulat mo ang aking pangalan sa aklat ng buhay at tulungan mo ko makapaglilingkod ako sa iyo. At sa iyo ko inihandog ang lahat ng mga bahagi ng buhay ko ngayon na ako'y born again na. Pagkayan ang pinagpipray mo in Jesus' name, ang sabi ng banal na kasulatan, you become born again and when you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ gives you the authority to become a child of God. Since you're made to become a child of God, you're also been made a co-heir together with the Lord Jesus Christ with all the heavenly inheritance from God the Father. So I thank you, everybody. I can see the name of Pastor Mimi Lasaga, yung CBLL Men's Ministry Director, at ito po yung ating isang broadcaster na kapatid na taga Bethel Church, Ormoc City, sir. Magandang gabi. Yung iyong station, di ba? Hot FM. Doon ka nagpe-preach ng gospel. Jonathan, yeah. Maraming salamat, Pastor kapatid Jonathan Edwards Bercero. Si Pastor Joseph Neil Bercero naman kanina, nanonood din. Si Litz Ovilie, kapitbahay. At saka yung aking batch na si Apolinar Labiste. Apolinar, nanonood din si Acela, yung ating kabatch mate ng 1982 St. Mary's Academy, Oslo, Cebu. Yan. So, maayong gabi diha kaninyong tanan. God bless you and may the Lord continue to shower His blessings upon your life that you will continue also to experience His goodness. Alright, si Reverend Jack Jacoba, ang atin pong section head ng section 1 ng Southern Tagalog District Council is also watching. Brother Manuel Manny Vicente and Sister Amor, you're also watching. Thank you so much. Brother Alan Nasul ng Manila Music, you're watching. Yeah, thank you so much. Brian Reyes, you're watching. Oh, Kathy Reyes, you're watching. Pastor Ismael, congratulations, Pastor Ismael Serna, sa napakaraming soul harvest kanina. God bless po sa ating mga taga, na-miss ko itong trip na ito eh. Doc Dan, Doktora Tess, Doktora Mickey, at Doktora Ludi, sa lahat po ng kabahagi ng Word of Hope's Medical and Dental Team. Alright, nananadyan po sa Visayas. Oh my goodness. Salamat sa Panginoon. God bless you. God bless you. And see you tomorrow. Pagpalain kayo ng Panginoon lahat-lahat. Ito po inyong lingkod, Bob Miramar. Uy, don't forget to like and also share. Tsaka subscribe nyo na din yung atin pong YouTube channel, Bob Miramar, The Day of Hope in the Lord Jesus. life. Okay? Shalom, shalom. See you next. Bye for now. Thank you. Thank you for your prayers.